Boston and other parts of New Brunswick. They're the American Hockey League champions of 1982. The Central League playoff is still going on. Indianapolis and Dallas, and they're the farm teams of the Islanders and the Canucks. Verdeen with the puck. A minute and 32 seconds left, and Brodeur is at the bench. Billy Smith covers up the puck, and Richard Brodeur is at the bench with a minute and a half to go. As you see, the time left. The Canucks are gambling with six attackers, and they're two goals down.
Gives an opportunity for that extra attacker and try to pull one out. But again, Howie, as far as talent is concerned, the Islanders reign supreme. But I have to give marks to the gutty performance of the Vancouver Canucks, from goaltender, everybody involved. They gave it their best shot. It's not over yet. It doesn't look that good for them that they will win this hockey game.
Well, it's been excellent hockey entertainment, and certainly it marks well for the Vancouver Canucks. They've got a lot of youngsters that are about to blossom. One thing for sure, next year they're going to training camp with tremendous depth.
Al Arbour from Sudbury, Ontario, and what a great job he's done as the National Hockey League coach. He came into Long Island. He had never missed the playoffs as a player or a coach. He said, well, we'll have to start making them here. A breakaway on an empty net. Bobby Nystrom makes it 3-0. Nystrom with 1:20 left.
You know, fellas, they have a pool in the newsroom that I bought a ticket for all season long. And tonight I picked number 19. So if there's a goal scored into an empty net in the last minute, I win it. Look at minute 20 seconds. I can't win nothing.
Now it's amazing how they break out of their own zone, find the open man, and Bob Nystrom able to pick up that puck and slide it easily into the open net. So it'll go 3-0 Islanders.
When you watch the Islanders perform tonight, and to a degree many of the Canucks, their ability to perform, the skills to skate well, to handle a puck, to give and take a pass is so important. And I think that more than anything else leads to Stanley Cup championship.
Bobby Nystrom's fifth goal of the playoffs at 18:40. And Brodeur goes back into the nets now with a 3-0 Islander lead, and a lot of the fans head for the exits, taking those white towels with them. They'll be back Sunday. That's a 5 o'clock Pacific time, 8 o'clock Eastern time for Sunday's fourth game. But you know that this performance by the Islanders, a flawless performance, will really deflate a lot of the Stanley Cup fever in Vancouver. The Islanders have been a perfect hockey team tonight. The Canucks had a two-man advantage during the first period for a minute and did not score. Now they're in full command with 35 seconds left on the clock. Billy Smith working on his first shutout of this Stanley Cup playoff. Ivan Boldrin, the Tiger Williams, didn't get by the Islander line as Ken Morrow flips the puck to Clark Gillies. He just dumps it in. 17 seconds left on the clock, and you can see those seconds tick away. The Islanders are one win away now from their third consecutive Stanley Cup. And no American-based team has ever done that. The only two teams who've ever won three in a row were the Canadiens and the Maple Leafs. And this game is over. Billy Smith celebrates the shutout.
Well, they gave a demonstration of perfect hockey, and if you hockey fans watching the game can see any flaws in this team, please write and let us know, because we haven't seen that tonight.
Well, certainly not tonight. They got excellent goalkeeping. Everybody on the defense played very, very well. They turned, got the puck, moved it up quick, and where it was necessary, took the man. And on the attack, oh, they're just a great bunch of grinders. Excellent hockey players in the corners. And when they got a chance to score a goal, made it count.
Billy Smith has his third Stanley Cup shutout, his first of 82. And the Islanders head to the dressing room, a happy team. This is Stanley Cup 82 from Vancouver.